Form is important. You know, form is very important in art, architecture, everywhere. So, see, in Japanese houses, they divide the, you know, they are very good in architecture, Japanese people. They are very conscious of it. We are not that conscious. Actually, our general public is not very conscious. So, in Japanese house, inside the house, they create lot of, you know, partitions, like that. See, they will make like this, you know, something like this. Then their house will, you know, they are very conscious. They will make bed like that, you know, they have, their beds are on the floor like this, you know. So now I want to show that how, you know, this space and this space and this area, how they are interconnected. And in architecture, this is the basic thing is that lines and space. So, and then of course design is also used in many places, like in our, that entry of this building, auditorium, you'll find that space is there, like that staircase, and some designs are made. So then designs also will be used like this, you know, a particular area. But I think that Japanese are very minimalistic. You know, they don't elaborate extra things, but I think they are so conscious, meticulously they create space which gives, which has a relationship, and also they create a inner rhythm. They come to a, you know, the whole space relation creates a feeling, a very quiet feeling probably, and which is very important, I think. So I think that this, we should be very conscious of this, actually, that how, you know, in our, say, in our Calcutta, you see streets, if you see, you see, for photograph it is interesting, in any ugly area, or, you know, darks, you know, if you make photography, it will be interesting. But as for, they may not be interesting. So in Calcutta street, you'll find that any irregular type of shapes, they have no harmony, no relationship. So I think that the Japanese houses, buildings, whatever I have seen, and also interior, you know, interior also is a form, designing is also a form of art. So we have, many of us are quite conscious of it, many of us are not. So I think in this, I wanted, so since young people are there, students, they will have to be conscious that each part, each space is reacting, you know, no space, every space reacts to us. Suppose there is a shadow on this floor, yeah, I can see, but you may not be seeing, or they are anywhere, you see each, you know, that shadow, if they are changed, they also react. So we know that the, how the space is reacting. You see, when the shadow changes, it react, you know, it gives a reaction to our mind. So, and the forms, like this form is there. There is a, you know, the iron is, you know, the rods are, you know, they are created, they have created a shape like that, making the iron rods. And if we make a little different, they also will react differently. So, each form, my point is that, that each form, each space is reacting to our mind. So we should be very careful about creating the form, creating the space. So that is the basic of architecture. Architecture and art are all linked together. So I mean, suppose a particular type of chair we design, interior decorators, they design a chair. So someone can make a little different chair with different design. So they both are different, and both react differently. So that means that one sort of structure or form or space acts differently than the other form of structure and space. So this is happening every time. So when we look at any form or space, it gives a different reaction to us. So my point is that people should be aware of it. They should not just ignore that for, this is why, we may not think of it, but actually it reacts. So if you have in your room also, if things are arranged differently, you get reacted. You suppose there is a big wall and you have five different objects to display. So you display in such a way that it creates harmony sometimes, and sometimes you can also create very hodgepodge way. So they may disturb you. So this is very interesting thing, that this is connected with our mind. Everything is connected with our mind and reacting to our mind. So it goes to our brain. So it is interesting that we normally do not really be aware of it, since we are not thinking of it. So we should start thinking of this thing. So another thing is, I was going to say that, say this is a line. As soon as I put one line like that, this is a straight line and creates an angle. Okay. But if this line is made like that, that straight line creates a feeling, but as soon as I make like this, what happens? It has a different feeling. This is like, the hand becomes like that, so it reacts to us. It is not the same thing how it was on this straight line, now it is becoming like that. I'm not showing a geometry, but I'm showing how it reacts to our visual, it reacts to our vision, reacts to our mind, reacts to our brain. So this is interesting, it changes, the magnetic relationship is changed. So I think this is what is actually inside the art activity. It is in sculpture or architecture or painting. When we make a line like that, say, what happens? All these lines are actually having some reaction to our mind. So this is how, suppose the other way, if I make another like that, which is different, also reacts to our mind differently. So this and this is not reacting same way. So all that means, the line and their, the way it is done, it is reacting to us, to our brain. Like also in reality, what happens? If you see a tree, a particular tree, and then the another tree which has a different form, we look at it against the bright sky, there is a dark tree, evening time we see, we look at it and we feel very pleased or we feel reacted. We say that, oh, beautiful thing. But the basic thing is, they create certain form, so we are reacting to it. So the basic thing is form. Another interesting thing, I was telling just an hour before that, say woman figure. Two woman figure. This is a young lady and this is an old lady. So we normally talk about women, but it is not the woman which signifies it. It is the form which makes it interesting. So when woman, you know, in a particular shape, is actually when we appreciate, but an old lady will not be appreciated. Why it is? The reason is that it is the form which is interesting. You know, a particular form gives a particular reaction. So this is, I am not elaborating it, the young people are there, I could have explained differently, but this is what. So I just want to say that it is not the gender is important, it is the form which is important. I think which I said is, you know, it is, you know, the it is the form which is important. The form creates the feeling. It is Now another thing is, you know, the movement, dancing movement, or you know, that dancing movement, or the sea waves, you know, when they come, you know, like this. It has, you know, rhythm. You know, these movements, you know, in nature we have also these movements, you know, how the sea waves happens, or the dancer, you know, they, you see, it is also in our mind, actually, you know, the why we actually like that form, why we like, is very interesting, that we, you know, in our system, psychology, or maybe for you know, in our body form, you know, in the physically, we are related to such forms. Suppose a form we see like this, we have a sense of rhythm when we see in the sea also, or when actually a dancer makes form like that when he moves the hand. So the interesting thing is that why we like it, why we, it reacts to us. This is interesting. I think that it is, we are physically oriented to accept or appreciate it. We have in our mind or physically it is there. I thought always that why it is like that. I felt that it must be that in, you know, there is a, you know, it is connected with our as what happens when we have a form, a dancer form, or something like that, or any particular picture, or, you know, also there, if we see in the mirror the same picture, the whole rhythm is sometimes destroyed. This shows us that it has a certain thing connected with the left and right of our brain. This is what it is my personal feeling, that it must be connected with that. So it is very much physical. whatever we get reacted, if I see something like this, a fog, or something like that. Each thing has a, you know, different texture it is creating. So this gives a different feeling in our mind. So why it is? Since it must be, it has a physical relationship with us. So when we look at it, I think these sort of forms are visible everywhere. I mean, this square form, line forms, you know, in a grill we can find it, in iron grill we also see, this also see. Each one has a particular attitude, particular style. So they react to our mind. We are reacting to see this. So this must be having certain relationship with our physical construction. So this is what I said, that it is also connected with the sense. It when it is seen in the mirror, then sometimes it changes, the reaction changes. So that means I said that it is one way, it is physical. Secondly, it is also the left and right of our brain system is connected. So this is something I'm just telling that people can start thinking about it, that how it is reacting. So I think this is very interesting, since in our existence everything is related like this. I mean, we don't know why something is happening, many things we don't know in our life. So anyway, this is what is my personal feeling, my understanding about it. And now I go to explain that how you know that this basic feeling is connected with also with our you see all art forms is you know, also in color. You know, I must talk about little bit of color. Color means, you know, there are many colors. You know, we say basic 7 colors: red, yellow, orange, green, say, these are random I am putting, blue, etc., violet. What happens to color, that if we put red and blue together, side by side, that reacts one way. Brown. These are not, this is all, there may be hundreds of colors, and we can make different name of that, but say that red and blue, if put together side by side, will be creating a particular sensation, whereas red and orange will have different, this combination will make a different thing. Or yellow and orange together also side by side will create a different relationship. Or also if we put 3 colors in a particular area, that also will create a different feeling. Violet and yellow also will have different feelings. So this we'll have to be very conscious of. Being artists, we are always thinking of the combination of colors. So color combination sometimes are sometimes opposite colors are there, sometimes homogeneous color is also there, like brown, red, orange. If I put together, they will be more or less same group of color, like blue, grain will be also nearer, since in grain there is blue already. You know, blue is made, grain is made out of blue and yellow. So when certain colors which have same group, that is homogeneous group, so they create certain sensation, and the opposite group like blue and red opposite, or blue or green, very opposite, red and green also will have opposite feeling, but they can be sensational, so they can create very strong sensation in our mind. So we'll have, these are the interesting thing happens. But then, why color reacts? Again, why color reacts? If we question to this thing, to ourselves, or if you question yourself, have you ever thought of it? Since, you know, the normal people are not artists, so they don't think, but we always try to understand why they react. So I think that this is interesting for people to think that why color reacts, or why, then it again comes, why there is, what is beauty? We talk about beauty. Why is beauty in a rose? This question I am putting to you says, you know, say a rose, I say that it is a beautiful flower. But where is the beauty? If we go to, you know, inside that thing, where is the beauty? So, actually I can try to explain whatever I can say about it. First is the form of the petals. It has a very sensitive feeling. A rose petals are very sensitive. You know, they are so finely prepared, you know, grown. You know, that whole thing is a, you know, very finer feeling is there. Secondly, that color also, see, of course, every color has a background to us. Being a social person, colors are related to our life also, very much. Say, red is connected with different, you see, different area of our life. Red is blood. And when we think of blood, so blood is, you know, one way we feel uneasy to see a blood, you know, when it is red. But then red, you know, when the sun goes down, then also it gets red and orange color. So that is another feeling. And then when red is as a, you see, a bindi on a, on our forehead, that is also another feeling. And then red when it is like kumkum is another feeling. So it has a psychological and social reason to appreciate color. So like green when we look at it, green is, you know, the paddy field. Green paddy field, green trees, so they are connected with that. So we have all this social relationship with color. Then color is also absolutely a fundamental thing at the same time. When it is put in abstract way, in a painting, the color holds its own quality as color, red, blue, green, whatever. So they create sensation or a type of feeling when put together or mixed together, or maybe three colors together, four colors together, or two colors together, or, you know, like that, or black and white together, you know, they create certain type of feeling. So they are all connected with our social, cultural reason. And every color has a meaning. Like black, we always use as sadness, darkness, like that. So this is all sorts of reason. Short for you. Okay. I finish. Oh, one painting is there. Maybe car. Oh, आपको बाद में देखा जाएगा.
আপনার একটা কাজ শুধু তাই নয়
চাই এটাতে একটু অসুবিধা হচ্ছে যে ব্ল্যাক ব্যাকগ্রাউন্ড তো I think I'm finished with this. Oh, for next time. Oh, it's a little bit.